June 3rd, 2016, and this video is concerning my efforts to reach out to news media for assistance concerning crimes committed against me, including the theft of several of my Social Security checks allegedly by government workers, and I'm trying to get an investigation. I wrote, I got this yesterday that it was deleted, my original email. Now, I sent it on the 28th originally. Now, if I go to, I actually have, she did read it on the 1st, and several others in her department read it on the 31st. But I haven't gotten any response back to get any of my documentation or to ask any clarifying questions or anything concerning that. And it was just deleted without any reaching out or contacting me for any supporting documents, nothing. Here was the original. But it's nothing other than what I've been reporting to other people as well. I did also contact in April a consumer justice for KTVT. This was the one. It's about the same thing. That was on April 10th. But then also on the 12th and 15th. I never got a response back of any type or any acknowledgement of any type from Consumer Justice, and it didn't bounce back. I didn't get anything like that. I also contacted Watchdog over with Dallas Morning News, and we did exchange several emails. Now I have some issues with the security on my phone, and he wanted some financial information that I emailed and said I felt uncomfortable giving it over the phone if I could provide it in some other way for my own security. And then I get an email that, you know, if I didn't give it over the, you know, didn't immediately give it over the, by email, then, you know, he wouldn't continue investigating. So, but I felt that was harsh. Jason Whiteley with WFAA, I contacted about the same issue, and, first, he tweeted to me that he was putting my issue, my report in front of his producers, but then I didn't hear any response back, and then I emailed him again, and he just didn't return my emails. What I believe is happening is that I'm being handled in a rude, dismissive, and unprofessional way to try to get me to respond with either an ugly or inappropriate email, to either say or do something inappropriate so that people can say, oh, well, that's why nobody's helping this woman. But that's not the case. And I believe that the reason is that I'm not getting any assistance is because of who the guilty parties are that are committing the crimes against me. There's, and so it's a matter of just dismissing me or discrediting me and just ignoring, ignoring the evidence, that I have and, where I'm not able to get any type of justice or exposure on the crimes that are being done to me. I've also reached out to different government agencies, trying to, including law enforcement, to try to get assistance. But I'm receiving a lot of resistance concerning this. Being a whistleblower, that's not unusual. But anyway, I'm going to be putting this video out so that people know my side of the story and to protect myself from inappropriate smears, and just inaccurate, deliberate mis and disinformation concerning me. Thank you very much for listening.